and welcome to Leer y Aprender es Divertido. Reading and learning are fun. We're at the Jefferson City Daycare Center today with some very cool 4 and 5-year-old kids. And we're going to read a story, one of my favorite stories, Corduroy Bear. Now, Corduroy is a little bear who wears green overalls and he wants to find a home. He has to live in a toy store right now and it's kind of lonely in there. But before we read the story, we're going to learn some Spanish words. Now these are words that are going to be in the story. Okay. Does anyone know who this is?
Corduroy Bear.
Corduroy Bear, that's right. And the way we say bear in Spanish is we say osito.
Osito.
Very good. Let's all say osito.
Osito.
Awesome job. All right. Now, does anyone know what these are? They're little stuffed teddy bears. Now, some people don't have stuffed teddy bears. Some people have dogs or cats or stuffed fish. They have animals.
I don't have bears.
Mm-hmm. So some people have an animal. Can we say animales?
Animales.
That's how you say animals in Spanish. Let's all say animales.
Animales.
Great job. And some people don't have animals, but they have a...
Doll,
that's right. Now this is a tough word, so listen carefully. The way we say doll in Spanish is muñeca.
Muñeca.
Okay, the first part's like a cow, moo, and then you just say muñeca.
Muñeca.
Good job. You guys are making this really easy. Does anyone know what this is?
A button.
A button, that's right. Corduroy Bear has buttons on the straps of his overalls. And the way we say button in Spanish is botón.
Baton.
Let's all say botón.
Where's the botón?
That's the button. Botón.
No, where's the botón word?
Hmm?
Where's the botón word?
At the bottom. Yeah. Baton.
Yep.
Baton.
All right. Does anyone know what this is?
Escalator.
An escalator. That's right. Sometimes when you go to stores or amusement parks, you'll have an escalator. It's like a staircase that moves. The way we say escalator in Spanish is escalera.
Escalera.
That's right. Let's
you
all say.
A lot of Spanish words.
I do. Let's all say escalera.
Escalera.
Great job. And what is this?
Mountain.
Mountain. That's right.
A snow mountain.
Corduroy Bear, when he sees the escalator, he thinks it's a mountain. So the way we say mountain in Spanish is montaña.
Montaña.
Let's all say montaña.
Montaña.
Excellent. Does everyone know what this is?
Castle.
Castle. And what's another name for a castle?
Palace.
Palace. That's right. Excellent. Now, Corduroy Bear thinks that the store he lives in is like a palace. And the way we say palace in Spanish is palacio.
Palacio.
Let's all say palacio.
Palacio.
That's a good word. Yeah.
Easy word.
What's this?
Bed.
Bed, that's right. You guys go to sleep in your beds at night?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
B-E-D. I have a bunk
bed. B-E-D is bed. Some people have bunk beds, and some people have big beds, and some people have little beds. And you guys are reading the Spanish. The way we say bed in Spanish is cama. Can you all say cama?
Cama.
Awesome. Does anyone know what this is?
House.
And sometimes we don't say house. Sometimes we say home.
Home.
Right? Like I want to go home.
Yeah.
And the way we say home in Spanish is hogar.
Hogar.
Can everyone say hogar?
H-O-G-A-R.
H-O-G-A-R. Hogar. And what do you think these two girls are?
Persons.
Do you think they like each other?
Yeah.
When you like someone, what is that person?
Friend.
Friend. That's right. This is their friends. And the way we say friend in Spanish is amiga.
Amiga.
Great job. Everyone say amiga?
Amiga.
Do all of you have amigas?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are all of you here amigas?
Yeah.
You're all friends? Great. Well, we're going to read the story, Corduroy. And Mishrita is going to read a page in English, and then I'm going to read that same page in Spanish. Just a second. And I want you all to listen very carefully and see if any of the words we talked about are in the book. Yep, what's your question?
Buzz Light, and like Buzz Light, he knows lots of Spanish.
He sure does.
He knows like
He knows lots of words.
He knows like amigos and all that.
Mm-hmm. So let's listen carefully and we'll see if you can learn as much Spanish as Buzz Lightyear. Okay? All right. Ms. Sherita's going to start the story for us.
All right, you guys are going to read the story of Corduroy Bear by Don Freeman, okay? Corduroy is a bear who once lived in the toy department of a big store. Day after day, he waited with all the other animals and dolls for somebody to come along and take him home.
Corduroy es un osito que un tiempo vivió en la juguetería de una tienda grande. Día tras día esperaba junto a los otros animales y muñecas que alguien viniera y se lo llevara a casa.
The store was always filled with shoppers buying all sorts of things, but no one ever seemed to want a small bear in green overalls.
La tienda siempre estaba llena de gente que compraba todo tipo de cosas, pero parecía que nadie nunca deseaba comprar un osito con pantalones verdes.
Then one morning, a little girl stopped and looked straight into Corduroy's big, bright eyes. "Oh, Mommy," she said, "look, there's the very bear I've always wanted." "Not today, dear," her mother sighed. "I've spent too much already. Besides, he doesn't look new. He's lost a button on one shoulder strap."
Luego, una mañana, una niñita se paró y miró directamente a las brillantes ojos de Corduroy. "Mira, Mami," dijo. "Mira, ahí está el osito que siempre ha querido." "Ay, no, mi amor," su mamá se lamentó. "Ya he gastado mucho. Además, no parece nuevo. Ha perdido uno de los botones de sus tirantes."
Corduroy watched them sadly as they walked away. "I didn't know I lost a button," he said to himself. "Tonight, I'll go see if I can find it."
Corduroy miró con tristeza como se alejaban. "No sabía que había perdido un botón," dijo para sí. "Esta noche voy a ver si lo encuentro."
Late that evening, when all the shoppers had gone and the doors were shut and locked, Corduroy climbed carefully down from his shelf and began searching everywhere on the floor for his lost button.
Ya tarde esta noche, cuando todos ya se habían ido y se habían cerrado las puertas de la tienda, Corduroy bajó con cuidado de su estante y por todo el piso empezó a buscar su botón perdido.
Suddenly, he felt the floor moving under him. Quite by accident, he had stepped onto an escalator, and up he went.
De repente, sintió que el piso se movía. De puro casualidad, se había parado en las escaleras automáticas, y hacia arriba se fue.
Could this be a mountain, he wondered?
No.
I think I've always wanted to climb a mountain.
¿Será esto una montaña? Se preguntó. Creo que siempre he deseado subir una montaña.
He stepped off the escalator as it reached the next floor, and there before his eyes was the most amazing sight. Tables and chairs and lamps and sofas, and rows of beds. "This must be a palace," Corduroy gasped. "I guess I've always wanted to live in a palace."
Cuando llegó al piso siguiente, se desmontó de las escaleras y ahí, ante sus ojos, estaba una vista muy sorprendente. Mesas y sillas y lámparas y sofás y filas de camas. "Esto debe ser un palacio," Corduroy dijo, maravillado. "Creo que siempre he deseado vivir en un palacio."
Mm. He wandered around admiring the furniture. "This must be a bed," he said. "I've always wanted to sleep in a bed." And up he crawled into a large, thick mattress. All at once, he saw something small and round. "Why, here's my button," he cried, and he tried to pick it up. But like all the other buttons on the mattress, it was tied down and tight.
Is that his button? No. Se paseó por todo el sitio admirando los muebles. "Esto debe ser una cama," dijo. "Siempre he querido dormir en una cama." Y se encaramó sobre un enorme y grueso colchón. De repente vio algo pequeño y redondo. "¡Caramba! Aquí está mi botón!" gritó. Y trató de recogerlo. Pero, al igual que los damas botones de un colchón, estaba firmemente amarrado.
He yanked and pulled with both paws until, pop, off came the button. And off the mattress, corduroy toppled, bang, into a tall floor lamp. Over, it fell with a crash.
Tiró y aló con sus patas hasta que, pum, el botón se desprendió y corduroy se cayó del colchón, dándose un topetazo contra una lámpara de piso grande. Cataplum. Cayó la lámpara.
Corduroy didn't know it, but there was someone else awake in the store. The night watchman was going his rounds on the floor above. When he heard the crash, he came dashing down the escalator.
Corduroy no la sabía, pero alguien más estaba despierto en la tienda. El guardia nocturno hacía su recorrido por el piso de arriba, cuando oyó el ruido bajo corriendo las escaleras.
"Now who in the world did that?" he exclaimed. "Somebody must be hiding around here."
"¿Quién pudo haber hecho esto?" exclamó. "Alguien debe estar escondido por aquí." "Who's hiding up there?"
He flashed his light under and over the sofas and beds until he came to the biggest bed of all. And there he saw two fuzzy brown ears sticking up from under the cover. "Hello," he said, "how did you get upstairs?"
Con su linterna alumbró por arriba y por debajo de las otras y de escamas hasta llegar a la cama más grande de todas. Y ahí vio dos orejas peludas de color marrón que salían de abajo de la cubricama. "Hola," dijo. "¿Cómo has subido hasta aquí?"
The watchman tucked Corduroy under his arm and carried him down the escalator and set him on the shelf in the toy department with the other animals and dolls.
El guardia puso a Corduroy bajo el brazo, lo llevó escalera abajo, y los colocó en el estante de la juguetería juntos a los otros animales y muñecas.
They thought that was a real teddy bear. That was a real bear.
Corduroy was just waking up when the first customer came into the store in the morning. And there looking at him was a wide, warm smile with the same little girl he'd seen only the day before.
Corduroy apenas se había despertado cuando vio a los primeros clientes entrar en la tienda en la mañana. Y ahí, mirándolo con una amplia y cariñosa sonrisa, estaba la misma niñita que justo había visitado el día anterior.
"I'm Lisa," she said. "And you're going to be my very own bear. Last night I counted what I've saved and in my piggy bank. And my mother said I could bring you home."
"Me llamo Lisa," dijo la niña, "y vas a ser mi propio osito. Anoche conté lo que había ahorrado en mi alcancía y mi mamá dice que puede traerte a casa."
"Shall I put him in a box for you?" the sales lady asked. "Oh, no, thank you," Lisa answered, and she carried Corduroy home in her arms.
¿Quieres que te lo ponga en una caja? Le preguntó la vendedora. No, muchas gracias, contestó Lisa, y en sus brazos se llevó a Corroy a casa.
She ran all the way up 4 flights of stairs into her family's apartment and straight into her own room.
Subió corriendo los 4 pisos de escaleras hasta el apartamento de su familia y fue derechito a su cuarto.
Corduroy blinked. There was a chair and a chest of drawers, and alongside a girl-sized bed stood a little bed just the right size for him. The room was small, nothing like that enormous place in the department store. This must be home, he said. I know I've always wanted a home.
Corroy pestañeó. Ahí había una silla y un gravetero, y al lado de una cama de niña estaba una camita justo del tamaño para él. El cuarto era pequeño, nada parecido al enorme palacio de la tienda. Este debe ser mi hogar, dijo. Sé que siempre he querido un hogar.
Lisa sat down with Corduroy on her lap and began to sew a button on his overalls. I like you the way you are, she said, but you'll be more comfortable with your shoulder strap fastened.
Lisa sentó a Corduroy en su regazo y comenzó a coserle el botón de sus pantalones. Me gustas tal y como estás, dijo, pero te sentirás más cómodo con su tirante amarrado.
You must be a friend, said Corduroy. I've always wanted a friend. Me too, said Lisa, and she gave him a big hug.
Seguro que tú eres una amiga, dijo Corduroy. Siempre he deseado tener una amiga. Yo también, dijo Lisa, y le dio un fuerte abrazo.
You read it at the first time.
See, Corduroy was able to find a friend at the very end, and he had his very own home. Isn't that what everyone wants, to have a friend and have a home?
Yeah.
Well, you guys did an awesome job today, and I'm very proud of you. I want to give yourselves a big round of applause. Thank you so much for listening to our story today. We're going to talk to the camera just a little bit later, but for now, I would like to say to everyone at home, thank you so much for watching Leer y Aprender es Divertido, Reading and Learning are Fun. We've had a great time at the Jefferson City Daycare Center today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't go anywhere. Make sure you stay tuned to JCTV.
Hi, my name is Jalen.
Say hi, Mom and Dad, or hi to your brothers and sisters. Who do you want to say hi to?
Hi, Mom and Dad.
All right, thank you. Say hi to someone.
My name is Ariel, and Loginfor.com, and I want you to thank for reading all the TV shows we've been through, and we have always been here, and thanks for coming to Jeff City Daycare. My name is Ariel. Thank you, Mommy and Daddy and Brother and Sissy.
Hi, my name is Brighton. Hi, Mom and Dad.
Hi, my name is Kyla. Hi, Mommy and Dada.
Hi, my name's Courtney Hill. Hi, Mom and Dad.
Hi, my name's Kevin. Hi, Mommy.
Hi, my name is Mackenzie. I hope you all have a good day.
Thanks, Mackenzie.
I love you, Mom and Dad.
Oh.
Hi, my name is Amaya, and my mom and daddy.
That's very nice. Thank you.